one of the manager with the CoreOS team, and this is a workshop called Hands-on with CoreOS Assembler. So I'll start with a very short presentation about what's Fedora CoreOS, give a bit more context about what's CoreOS Assembler and what we use it for. And then we can step into like the lab. We have like a lab and a set of instructions that you can run to get a better idea and use by yourself CoreOS Assembler and start to build Fedora CoreOS. So quickly, Fedora CoreOS is a Fedora edition since Fedora 37. It's focused at running container workloads, so either on single nodes or in clusters. In clusters, it's used with OKD, which is the open source project for OpenShift, but with other flavors of Kubernetes. It was the result of the merge between Atomic Host and the Container Linux from like the CoreOS, the company. And it's really like a merge of like different technologies from those two projects. So in the philosophy, there are like three main points. Automatic updates, so we really want users to consume, to have like the latest security updates, to have like the latest version of their software, and we want them to have that. They don't have to care about it. It's going to be provided automatically for them by the operating system. Automated provisioning, so we want it to be very easy to provision like 1 or 1,000 nodes. They should all start the same, be the same. That's the philosophy behind that. And immutable infrastructure, so we want a solid operating system that you can control and where you provide updates that doesn't break, or you can roll back and have like a more robust update model. So in order to do that, the release of Fedora CoreOS is a bit different from other Fedora variants. We have like three streams: next, testing, and stable. And the idea is like if you actually run your workload on the stable stream, you also try to test in advance the updates that are coming in Fedora CoreOS. So we encourage our users to run also testing and next, so they can provide the feedback early, and that gives more chance to have like a very stable stream. All right, so a bit more, just like a few words about CoreOS Assembler. So CoreOS Assembler was built specifically to build like Fedora CoreOS and also RHEL CoreOS. And it's pretty much like a Swiss Army knife for like building a distribution. It contains all the tools and all the applications needed to build a CoreOS system. And there are like a few key aspects, like key design decisions that were taken when the tool was developed. First, it was needed to actually be able to run that tool on your laptop. Like you could just like use that tool and don't need anything else. So for that, it's running in container and it runs on everyone's laptop. You don't need to have like some specific settings or so on. It's also the same tools that you use for like the development process, so that you can use in your laptop to develop, to build new features or test new features. And it's the same thing that is actually running to build the production build, like that we use in the build pipeline. And yeah, and as you will hopefully see in the workshop, this is a great way to quickly iterate. And because it's so easy to build this, to use that tool to build Fedora CoreOS on your laptop, you can quickly make change, test the changes, investigate if there are problems, and it's a very iterative way of developing. Any questions on that, or like before we start the lab? I just gave like a 5 minutes overview, but if there are more questions, I'm happy to go for. Okay, so for the lab, we prepared like some lab machines in the cloud that you can access. I'll give you the details. If I find where my cursor is, here it is. Okay, so I'm going to give you a number that you can use here, like so lab user, and the X you just replace by the number that I'm going to give you. So we're going to start with number 1, 2, 3, and 4. So to connect, you can just like run in the command line SSH, lab user, your number, the IP address, and the password to log in on the machine, it's flock23 CosaLab. If you have any trouble logging in, just raise your hand and I'll come and try to see if I can help on it. Once you're logged in, so you should be able to follow. We have like the tutorial step on this address. So github.com/coreos/coreostutorials. And then you can just look for the CoreOS Assembler file. Any issue or the typing? Yeah. Maybe next year we'll do a QR code or something like this, making it easier. So hopefully the tutorial should be relatively self-service, like you should be able to go on your own. But yeah, let me know if there is any questions or anything that is not clear, not working. Don't hesitate, and I'll come.
UID 1000, I guess.
Say again?
This assumes you have UID 1000, I guess, yeah.
Yes. Ah, yeah. But you shouldn't matter. Yeah. That's a good question. I don't think it matters too much for the build. Yeah. Yeah.
I don't remember which number is which of those, but I guess the where it says 1000, it should be my actual.
Your actual UID, yeah. Sorry, say again?
Or did I misunderstand those ID mappings? I mean, in the bash function here it says 1000. And so it's a login, I get gives you 1001. So should, if you replace here, if you 1001, and here I should instead use a different ID map here.
I don't think it matters. Yeah, it doesn't matter. Yeah, so you can just copy the. Yeah, you can just copy the function directly and don't care about the UID. It might matter for some specific test or thing like that, but for what the lab does, it shouldn't really be significant. You You can use user 5, Adam, if you want to do that. Okay, one thing that will matter, that's the good thing to do with multiple users. When we tried, we had only one user. Okay. In the lab, when you copy paste that function to use later, the COSA function. Well, you need to put your user number behind the COSA name. So just like COSA 1, COSA 2, COSA 3, COSA 2. Because it's pretty much it's running containers in Podman. And you cannot have like the same name for like multiple containers. So you should be okay if you already done it. So. Let me know if you have like a weird error, I'll come. the first pull, like the first time you run COSA, can take a bit of time because it's pulling the container and the container is quite big. So. Yeah. It's usually better. So the machines are on AWS. So usually it's fast, but it can deepen. anyone's got the build already, or did you manage to go? Yeah.
Cool. Sorry.
Did you manage to get Fedora CoreOS build already after the COSA fetch COSA build? Yeah. Not yet. Yeah. Okay. How do you? Should have like with libvirt.
I can see the QMU process with.
Yeah.
Like arguments.
Yeah, I think.
See what's happening.
Yeah.
Okay, you don't remember either.
No, you can't really do. You need to go from inside COSA because you will have like, so in the COSA, in the container image, you have like all the tools installed to run the virtual machines, not on your, on the lab. So if you see in the, did you have like the COSA run dev shell console? It's a bit inception how it works. Because
yes.
Pretty much all the virtualization.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So if I execute it,
yeah. Then you will be, yeah, you will have like all the libvirt and all the comments. That's really what, like the, that was one thing for, like one of the design decisions of COSA is that you really have like everything inside the same container image or binary, so. Yeah.
So. Would you keep track of where I am?
It's kind of, yeah. It does a lot of magic for yourself, so. Yeah, so you need to exit then. Yeah, so that's the. Yeah, you have to exit the
taken.
The test name? I haven't set up for the complete test name. It's a good feature request. At least feature suggestion.
I can open the tickets.
that should be 1,003 there, and then you reduce the
64,002.
Try that.
Okay. Let's see what
I may misremember things. But
worth a try.
While I get through customer service, you can give it a try. Technical support. Have you tried rebooting? And did you plug and unplug? What's your user?
1,002.
No, the lab user number two. Number
yes,
two.
User, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. You have the same also? Yes. Which user? You see the conversation anyway. In Slack, we post it.
This thing run it once, it works running, but then the next person running it might not, because it's in slash var slash tempt, which I think is shared by, it might not be user specific, I don't know.
Should have said this is the first time we do this workshop. So you're guinea pigs. Thank you for your contribution. Set enforce
yeah.
Zero.
Yeah, when you close the kernel.
Okay.
You would have failed.
Yeah, and the problem is that the var TMP error. .mp or .mp, and then it's the same graphic site.
And like if you see it's owned by user 19, no? Like all the files are owned by lab user 19.
19, yes.
Which is the user we used to test the workshop, so it works.
Yeah, it is from 4019, so that's when you tested it.
Yeah, it worked before, but now that we do the...
I see that.
Yeah, when we do the multi-user, it's...
Just bear with us 1 minute.
If you remove that, I stop my command before he starts his.
Yeah, it's like a serial. You have to take a ticket. We have one of the team members looking at it. Is your battery now?
10%.
Cheers. Just like, you know, the first bash command, like the COSA, you can just do that and pull the container and you should the lab machine is really just convenience.
So I was curious if I go back to it afterwards.
Yeah, you should do, everything should work.
It's not provisioned in a special
command. No. That was one of the philosophy behind this tool. That it works the same everywhere.
Okay, so we should have a fix. It's like iterative development. So if you refresh the tutorial, the markdown file, and pretty much in the first bash function where you define the COSA alias, just remove the slash bar, like the volume for, you can just recopy the alias and you should have it. Recopy paste that one. You have 1 minute left. We'll leave the lab machine on anyway, like for like today, so we can continue. The actual tutorial?
Yeah, so I can find it again. I mean.
Yeah, yeah. So I'll put it in the session, in the scheduled session. And if you ever have like any questions or anything related to this, there's the Fedora CoreOS channel on Matrix or IRC, and you can just pop up and ask, like, yeah, I'm trying to run this, it doesn't work, help, and be happy to help. What time is the bus thing? Do you know? It's like half past. The bus, yeah, for like the half past. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Say again. Ah, yeah. Thanks, Anka. Thanks, everyone.